7:24 on this Tuesday morning, and there is Roch Voisine hard at work with his team on this brand new album called Movin' On, Baby. Thank you so much for joining us this morning.
Pleasure.
Last time you were here, we were talking about the Olympics, and then you mentioned that the new album was...
I was sort of working on something else.
Yes.
Yeah, but we never say.
You never...
Because you never know when it's going to be released and when it's actually going to be done. Actually, it's never done.
Okay, we were just talking about that during the break. You know, because in my head, musicians like you have been around, you know, you have longevity, meaning that you're a perfectionist. You go back, you really work hard. How do you ever know that an album is over and you're finally ready to release it into the world?
You don't. so you need someone behind saying, okay, it's enough.
Let's go. Enough.
We got street dates. Usually it's a street date. You know, I would love to release an album and then re-release it a year later. You know, it's, but no, you have to, eventually you go, okay, you sort of have a feeling, we can't bring this any further.
Yeah.
You know, we've pretty much said what we wanted to say, and it sounds pretty good, and then you sort of have to let go.
You have to let it
it's
go.
It's the art of letting go.
The art of letting go, and also with you, you have such a dedicated fan base, and you know, I've seen it. They put a little bit of pressure on you. Is that something they put pressure because they want more from you? Do you feel that in the process of making these albums?
I've educated them in they're used to an album a year,
yeah,
like a project or something a year for 30 years.
Yeah,
I don't view it as pressure. I think it's great.
Yeah.
But the hard part of a new project is not to please your hardcore fans, is to go and get the other, you know, what I call in French we say les incertains.
Ooh,
you know,
it's
the people that sort of like you, but you know, we'll see, you know, and there's a lot of people there, you know,
and that's
the big challenge. Yeah. Pull them in. That's the big challenge.
You've said that this is really a collection of basically, a lot of this comes from an old box of tapes. Explain that to me.
Well, come on. It's been 12 years.
Yes.
I have no excuse. I'm sure you have. The next question is, why 12 years?
Yes.
We could sit down and talk about it for a while. But the fact is it's been 12 years. And I've been writing songs for a long period of time and even way further down than 12 years, and I keep them in boxes, I keep them on tapes. Some of those songs are that old, and before sitting down and writing new songs, I already had like 60-70 songs to pick.
Wow.
So I just wanted to make sure I was not going to leave anything behind in some
old box.
An old box, or on a tape, or in the middle of a tape.
Yeah.
So I sat down, you know, like for 6 or 7 days at home. I collected all those tapes from way back when, and the toughest part was not to listen to all those. The toughest part was to find a cassette tape player.
The cassette tape player.
That took me longer than actually a week.
Well, the album is called Movin' On, Baby. Tell
maybe.
Us a little. Maybe
Movin'
not
on
baby.
Maybe. Yeah.
Maybe that's just me.
It's a good title.
Let me just say that he is a very handsome man. So that may have been a Freudian slip that happened
good.
Right there. Let's talk about the concert. There it is up on the board.
Yes.
This is going to be a big one, of course. And it's right near the holiday season. If you want to bring a friend, if you want to offer that as maybe an early Christmas present, Roch Voisine, thank you so much for joining us.
My pleasure.
Again, the album is Movin' On, Maybe, and not Baby. That's just me being silly. I apologize for that. Roch Voisine. All right, thank you so much.
Thank